Hey everybody, my name is David Pegler. This is your pre-London Outlook for December the 2nd. Happy Tuesday, everybody. Let me remind you the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. Myself and none of the other currency coaches are going to make any trade recommendations during the course of a day. But what we will do is conduct some fundamental and technical analysis and hopefully help you put together some highly profitable trade plans for the day. And please remember that trading is always very risky business and do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success on a demo account. Okay, guys, a pretty good day is there. I mean, might as well just cover this euro yen, considering that's the one we looked at yesterday. Let me just flip this to a 15-minute. The trade plan worked out pretty good. I mean, you know, the direction here, it was very nice. We had this, you know, if you missed the original drop, we had this 120.15 area identified as support. If you guys remember that, I think I had it as 16, and I just shuffled it down a little bit to correct it exactly to the bottom of that wick. I like body sometimes, but sometimes the wicks look good. And this one had overlapping support previously. And even if you missed the original drop, not a problem. Just hang tough with it. You know, patience, patience, patience is one of the big properties of successful traders, is to exercise good patience and discipline and wait for the entry so they can trade on their terms and not the market's terms. And when we when things pulled back here, you know, many ways to approach this. If I just zoom in just a touch, you know, you could have popped up the fib of the drop itself, okay, and then just, you know, when you started to see a little bit of red of the 382, you took a little shot to the downside. All right, alternatively, you shorted at the roll reversal of the previous support, now became resistance, and you short. Okay, and it was worth the you know, a couple hundred pips to you. So I don't think at all a bad trade plan. You know, we were looking, we were bouncing off these moving averages all day long, and then we finally got a nice breakdown right at the London Open. And that negativity from that China PMI just continued through the whole day, and we just kept getting a barrage of poor news. You know, the outright stellar performer was the pound. I mean, it was the weakest currency out here all day. But you know, since we covered this this euro yen, you know, this trade plan also worked out fairly nicely. Not as many pips, but you know, it got it handled at the end of the day. Big down day in the intermarket. And as a result, you saw all the yens fall in unison, and particularly Kiwi and Aussie and Pound yen all got killed yesterday. Okay, so today poses a whole bunch of new challenges. We are very much at a point of decision here, folks. I mean, we dropped so far yesterday on so many things that now we're kind of in a pickle a little bit. Let me show you this Dow Jones chart. Expand this a little, and you know, I was talking about us getting, you know, nothing goes up forever, folks. Even you know, we've been dropping precipitously. You know, now we've seen a little, now we're seeing a 1,000 point retracement. But even within the 1,000 point retracement, I expect corrective waves, right? And that's effectively what we got yesterday. So if we just break this little, you know, retracement wave down, you're gonna have periods like this within the larger retracement wave, and that's effectively what we got. Okay, I didn't expect it all in one day, but such is life these days. And if I just zoom out completely, you'll notice that this is exactly a 50% Fibonacci retracement of the whole move up. Okay, of the whole rally from 75. This is exactly a 50% fib, a perfect place for profit taking, okay, which is where we stopped yesterday afternoon, where the precipitous sell-off got halted in its tracks. Well, now what? You know, because now you got, we had a classic place of bull and bear fights. All right, so you're absolutely gonna have to remain flexible today. Although the charts have all been pointing down. Down for a day. This could be a day where they go up. All right, I'm not willing to go out on a limb and say that, because I think that until until these hourly 21s almost across the board on the yens break, there is really no reason for you to want to long things. Okay, but I did want to point out to you that we are at a 50% retracement, so of the move up. Okay, so if we're gonna head up, this would be a very logical place for that to happen. Very, very logical. All right. Moving forward from here, let me take you to. I wanted to show you that the dollar index should also help us out a little bit today, just to add to the conundrum of things. This is a dollar index, folks, 4 hour chart. Okay, she was steaming up in pretty extravagant fashion. A little trend line produced itself, kind of a double top, triple top deal. It fell, no big surprise there. And now it's retraced back, but it's finding roll reversal on this trend line plus the 618 Fibonacci retracement of the drop itself. So this is also at resistance. So we have our Dow at support, and we have our dollar index at resistance. You're kind of getting what I'm saying? We're right here at a decision-making point in things, because if we break up here, we're gonna go visit the top, and then and then we're gonna see another significant down day for the pound, potentially for the euro, up day for the Swissie, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Another big down day for Aussie and Kiwi, and the list goes on. However, this is a point where we could start to see, some drops on this dollar index, and that's going to mean an up day. And I just don't know at this point. It's exactly at the point in time here where we're gonna see a where we're gonna see bulls and bears wanting to fight some stuff out. All right. So I, as a retail trader, have no business being part of the decision-making process. All right. When the big boys have worked out direction, well, then I'm all aboard. Okay, all aboard. But until that's happened, I've really no business being in the market. Okay. That said, all right, let's go back to our little euro yen here. Check that. Actually, I'd like to look at pound yen daily chart. All right. And if you look at the weekly, the pound yen weekly just looks very, very heavy. But this is a daily, and you'll notice this, we're right at the bottom, guys. But you see the lower highs, etc. That, my friends, is bearish by itself. Okay, the acceleration from the top side down is inherently bearish. But on an intraday level, is it ready to break, break lower today? I don't know. Okay, if you have a look at this daily, you'll notice the big gap between the 5 EMA and present price action, and it's not uncommon to see price go up and meet that five at least halfway, and that's going to put us at 140, 150 or so. All right, easier said than done. Okay, what my proxy is today moving forward are these hourly 21s. Okay, you'll notice. Sorry, just reverting you back to the daily here. You notice even with that big drop yesterday, how the MACD is still not wavered. I know it's kinked a little bit, but it's still not wavered. It's still desperately pointing to the upside. Granted, we got a stochastic cross, but MACD is still absolutely pointing upwards here. So, it's not all guns blazing to the downside yet. You should absolutely entertain the fact we might actually have a little bit of upside here if that 50% retracement holds on the Dow. Do you see how important this stuff is starting to get? How all this is matching with each other? The dollar index, the 10-year T-note, the Dow Jones, and where we are technically on these yens. Okay, we're absolutely at support, but there is room a little bit to the upside. However, our bias is obviously down, and I'm going to continue to look for reasons to sell. However, if they're starting to prove that they want to go up, I'm not going to turn a blind eye to that, given that support we see on the intermarket. All right. So, my little trade plan for today is look at a great angle and separation on the 21.55 here, and that means that you can sell with some. You can sell with some level of confidence around this 140.60 area. It's old visual support. It's roughly today's central pivot. It's also the hourly 21, more importantly, sharply pointed down. Okay, you absolutely want to be looking to sell at that level, all right? Because even if price doesn't make lower lows, more than likely you can get your stop to break even and then some. Okay, it's gonna possibly even drop, 100 pips, be a nice little trade. All right. If at that point we start to look like we're gonna, 50%, make a 50% retracement of this swing high, well, then maybe we're gonna find some support around this 139.20 area, and that will be your trigger that you need to get long, maybe looking for 142 and change. Okay, but I really expect this 21 on the hourly to be some level of resistance and a catalyst for us to roll over if and when we're gonna roll over. So that's what I'm looking at across the board on these ends, on those hourly 21s, absolutely as a level of resistance. If you just look at Aussie today, this is kind of the chart pattern that I'm looking at. You could consider this a 21 EMA hit. Even if it's hit it, it's gonna drop significantly. And if you pop up a little fib, we call them reverse fibs, but they're just drawn traditionally just against the run of traffic. Then you're gonna come down into our little happy fib zone between a 382, 50%. And then if you start to see some green, some higher lows, etc., that'll be your trigger to go long, because then you've got every opportunity then to break the 21 EMA. But that doesn't mean to say you don't go short there, because that is where you'd be selling at resistance in the context of a downtrend. Okay, you do not want to be selling after there's already been selling, folks. That's you want to sell at resistance in the context of an uptrend and buy at support in the context of a downtrend. All right, I mean, that's really all that trading boils down to in a nutshell. Okay, then it's just up to you to define trend in its dynamic sense. Okay, so that's the chart pattern I'm kind of looking for on this pound yen and all the yens for that matter. Obviously, if we break those lows longer term, if we can break out here longer term, well, then we're looking for, 135 and then some. But that's gonna take another bout of down here on the market. And a big day yesterday, right at support now. Either consolidation or some upside would not be crazy to expect. Okay, so take it as it comes. We've ironed out at least support and resistance here, folks. This isn't going to be a rocket science day, but it's definitely going to be a day where you should not be aggressive. You should let price prove itself to you a little bit before we have some direction and be completely flexible to which way we're going to go, given all that intermarket support and resistance you see. Okay, this is your pre-London outlook for December the 2nd. We'll catch up with you tomorrow. My name is David Pegler. Good luck further today, folks.